Ghrelin come punch in your face when you're hungry, but Leptin's like, no, I got the magic shield. I can defend myself. You can't get through this. It's like a friggin' force field. Coach Greg, and today we're going to discuss how to burn more calories without doing cardio. Obviously, to lose weight, you have to be in a calorie deficit. That's a measure of calories in, calories out, or energy in, energy out. Doesn't matter how you explain it, you need to be in a deficit to lose weight. Rather than focus on the calories in portion, today we're focusing on calories out, and how do you make that go up without doing cardio? Obviously, everyone needs to do cardio, but on top of that, what can we do to burn off more calories and improve our metabolism? Who doesn't want to improve their metabolism? Everybody wants a better metabolism, and here's how to do it in 10 easy points. Follow these 10 tips and you will for sure burn off more calories without doing cardio. Tip number one, build more muscle. The more muscle you have, the more calories you're gonna burn, even if you're sitting or sleeping. Muscle is metabolically active and requires energy. The more muscle you have, the more energy you need, and the more you burn off. How are you gonna build this muscle? Well, obviously you're going to the gym and you're training harder than last time. Tip number two, eat more protein. Why? Well, it's not just to build more muscle, it's also because protein has a higher thermic effect. What does that even mean? Well, a thermic effect of food is how many calories you digest in the digestive process. When you eat chicken compared to candy, you burn more calories digesting the chicken than you do eating the candy. So if you eat the same amount of calories, the energy expenditure when eating chicken is going to be higher than when eating candies. Okay, so you're affecting the calories out by choosing the kinds of foods to eat. Foods that are high in protein burn off more calories. Number three, eat more fiber. Same reason, increase thermic effect of food. You are going to burn off more calories eating things that are high in fiber, like fruits and vegetables. And yeah, fruit has fructose, but who cares? It also has fiber. And fiber takes more energy to digest. You're gonna poop a lot of it out even. Some of the fibers have 2 calories, some have none. It doesn't really matter though, because when you eat a diet high in fiber, you're burning off more calories. The net result is you lose weight. Number four, eat more low calorie dense foods. Like in my freaking cookbook. Everyone knows this by now. Low calorie dense foods means you get to eat a lot of food, like a huge jumbo sized bowl, and it hardly has any calories. Low amount of calories, large amount of food. What happens because of this? You eat it and it fills up the stomach. The stomach stretches out slightly. You might look like you have a food baby for a couple hours, but what is the effect? The effect is increased leptin. Leptin is like the anti-ghrelin hormone. Ghrelin come punch in your face when you're hungry, but leptin's like, no, I got the magic shield. I can defend myself. You can't get through this. It's like a friggin' force field. Keeps them from getting you. Leptin keeps you full and happy. I'm a full, happy person. I don't need to binge. I don't need to eat. Leptin is our friend. When you eat low-calorie dense foods, you have more leptin, which is stored in the fat hormones. When you get really, really lean, you have less leptin. When you're really obese, more leptin, you're more full, and you're less hungry. That's why people who gain 50 pounds eventually, hopefully, they're not as hungry anymore. So eat more low-calorie dense foods, leptins increase, you are then full, and when you're full, you're not likely to binge because you're full and satisfied. Number five, consume enough essential fats like omega-3 fatty acids. And for me, I eat things like salmon, fatty fish, avocado, and so on. That allows you to have the proper hormonal balance. As you know, you do need some fats to have proper hormone efficiency in the body. If you cut out all fats from the body, you're not gonna work so efficient now, are you? You need healthy fats in your diet to function normally. Cut out all essential fats and you're not gonna function efficiently. You need to eat some essential fats in your diet. You don't need a crap ton, you don't need burgers and fries, but you do need some healthy fats in your diet. So don't skip out on the healthy fats. Try to consume at least 3 servings of fatty fish a week. If you don't, be sure to take omega-3 fatty supplement pills at least every day to ensure you have some omega-3s in your body. Number 6, drink more water. Too many people walk around dehydrated, and when you're dehydrated, you don't function efficiently. Your neat, non-exercise activity thermogenesis is going to be decreased. You might fidget less, you might bob your head less, you might just become less active. You're subconsciously going to be moving less, which results in fewer calories. Also, when you drink more water, you're getting that increased leptin, which is making you feel full, and you end up eating less calories. Less calories, you're gonna be leaner because you're in a deficit. Don't neglect how important it is to drink water. And when I say water, I don't mean just plain water. I mean anything with fluid, like Diet Pop, Diet Kool-Aid, watermelon, anything with liquid in it. You need to be hydrated. You need your water. Number 7, try to eat a little bit more often. If you're doing an intermittent fasting diet, or if you're on OMAD, and you're only eating once or twice a day, or you're fasting all the time, try to eat more meals. Eating more often throughout the day will help to keep ghrelin at bay. It will. If you fast 16 hours, ghrelin's coming for you. You know he's out there. He's looking for you. If you eat every 5 hours, for example, it's like, hey, no, I'm going to eat. It's okay, ghrelin. You don't need to punch me in the face. I'm good. I'm going to eat. 5 hours later, you see he's starting to creep up. Nope, I'm just going to eat. So you spread out your meals. Try to eat 3, 4, maybe even 5 times a day. Don't eat more than that. 3 to 5 times a day is great. And that keeps ghrelin from coming after you. And it keeps you from overeating and binging. Go too long without eating. The body senses, oh my goodness, what's going on here? The next time you get some food, you best be eating all of it and then some. That's what happens. Number 8. Start drinking coffee. It's a stimulant and it keeps your hunger down. Not only does it help you burn more calories through increased need expenditure, it also keeps you from eating more food. Dual benefit. You eat less and you burn off more. And coffee has hardly any calories, but I'm warning you, don't just throw in a bunch of sugar and cream and think it has the same effect. If you drink 200 calories in your coffee, yeah, sure, it's going to burn more calories, help you move more and eat less, but not enough to compensate for the 200 calories you had. So be careful when drinking your coffee. Be sure to have low-calorie creamers and low-calorie sweeteners. Number 9, you need to sleep. If you're not sleeping enough, especially those who are on shift work and you're sleeping during the day and then you're sleeping during the night, that's really hard. That increases cortisol and that can affect how many calories you're able to burn, okay? Can slow down your metabolism. We don't want that. We want maximum calorie expenditure. How great is that? If you sleep more, it not only helps boost your metabolism, but it also helps prevent you from eating more. It keeps ghrelin at bay again. People who don't sleep enough, ghrelin, it's just such a bad person. Ghrelin! Why are you picking on us so much? Ghrelin comes out, watch it eat more. So please, try to sleep more and keep that ghrelin over there, okay? Number 10, reduce stress. How many of us have so much stress? There's so much stress. You go to work all day, your kids are screaming at you, you got no money, you're getting cheated on, all this crap's going on in your life. Everyone is stressed out. You need to learn how to relax. Exercise does it for me, but this is not a video about exercise. Exercise does it for me, it releases the stress. Maybe it could be yoga. Maybe you could watch a good movie. Relax, get a massage. Just relax and have that stress reduced. If you reduce stress, less hormones are going to be screwed up in your body and you're going to have a better metabolism, okay? So that's the top 10 list, but guess what? Here's a bonus. Listen to this. The top 10 list is for sure going to help boost your metabolism and burn more calories, but doing cardio at a moderate pace is going to make more difference in fat burning and in your health than following this entire list put together. That's right. It's more important to do cardio if you want to lose weight than doing all 10 of these combined. So although these 10 lists will help you burn more calories, doing cardio will help more. And what kind of cardio should you do? Moderate pace cardio. If you do HIIT and you go so crazy all out all the time, that can actually increase your stress and make it hard to recover. You don't want to go too hard. If you're an advanced athlete, no problem, do the HIIT cardio. But if you're a normal person, you lift weights, you're trying to be fit, doing moderate pace cardio is the best because you not only can do it now, you can do it later. You can do it forever. It's not gonna burn you out. You're gonna wanna do it. You're gonna keep doing it. And the best form of cardio is the one you will do for a lifetime. Not the one you'll do for a 3-month challenge or a 30-day challenge. You wanna do cardio and do it for the rest of your life. Hope you learned something. GregDucette.com for coaching. Greg Doucette, IBU Pro. Bloop it up 2 videos. And until next time, I am out.